And when your name was recorded there, it's recorded in the room or the place that you showed up, but it's also recorded in heaven, and heaven keeps an account of what you have coming to you based on whether or not you showed up. You're not going to receive what you should have received if you didn't show up. It's a scriptural principle where whenever there was a meeting where something significant happened, there was a record of the names. And those names are not only recorded in the room or meeting that you showed up in, but they're actually recorded in heaven, and it has something to do with the blessing of God in our lives. In Acts chapter 1, talking about the upper room, and it says that there was 120, do you know what was gathered there? What was gathered in the upper room is about 120 what? Not people, not disciples. There was 120 names gathered in the upper room. And that's why it's so significant that you show up, so that your name can be there, that your name can be attached to the significant thing that happened, especially kingdom things. I want to bounce off of Sawang's post here yesterday in VC Leadership. He says, good leaders always show up, and if he or she can't make it, they communicate. We want people to show up, and a lot of times people may feel, well, that's for our benefit, the people that they're showing up for, but it's actually for the benefit of the people or the detriment of the people that show up or don't show up. And again, always in the Word of God, there's a record of the names of the people that were there for anything significant that happened. And I want you to realize how important it is that you take physically, bodily, take your name and put it where the significant things are going to happen, all right? In the church, in the leadership meetings, in whatever it may be, Bible college, whatever you need to be at, you be there. I mean, you don't get paid if you don't show up for work, true? And you won't receive the benefits if you don't show up for where the benefits are being distributed from or being, you know, released from. So I just want to talk to you for just a moment about your name, your good name, sir, and what it actually carries and what it actually means. The Greek word for name in Acts 1:15 is onoma. If I say, you know, Bob's coming over, and you're like, oh no, not Bob. Because that name conjures up all of the ideas, all of the things, all of the experiences, all of the reputation that you've heard about Bob. And maybe I'll say, well, you know what, Jim's coming over, and you're like, oh yeah, I can't wait to meet Jim. And that's what your name does. And your name is something that you build. You have to build it one little piece at a time. And so the question is, what do people feel when they hear your name, when they hear you're coming over? And that whole thing is what you need to build, okay? All right, look at this. This is in my Bible concordance here. And it says that your name is used for everything which the name covers, okay? Like I said, how does somebody feel when your name is mentioned? Everything is involved in that name, okay? Everything that the thought or the feeling of which is aroused in the mind by mentioning, hearing, remembering the name. For example, one's rank, authority, interest, pleasure, command, excellence, deeds, and the part you play, all right? Especially the part you play on the team. And you have a great or a poor reputation, and it mostly comes from showing up or showing up late or not being involved, not being committed, and not doing the work. And that's how your name is built, guys. And that's where the blessing of heaven is released over our lives. And so I want you to think about this. Every time you show up or don't show up, not only are you receiving or not receiving what you could have received, the blessing that's there, the potentials that's there. I mean, you know, dinner time, if you don't show up, you don't eat. But also, it's the idea that's built around your name, the reputation that's built around your name. In the Psalms, many times it says things like, I will wait in the presence of the Lord with your saints, for your name is good. And that's one of the reasons, one of the things that attracts us to God is his good name. And then in Proverbs 22:1, it says, a good name is to be chosen rather than great riches, loving favor rather than silver and gold. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches. When you show up, it makes your name great. And when your name is great, you not only receive the blessings from heaven, but the influence and the impact that you'll have in the earth and leadership is influence.